Also, we have additional relations. You see here these three lines corresponds to the equilibrium equations of the rigid inclusions. This is forces in the direction x1. This equilibrium for forces in the direction x2. We should integrate over the boundary of the rigid inclusions. Also, we should integrate over D and jump of the forces going from thin inclusions, as well as for vertical forces along x2. And the last line corresponds to the bending moment is equal to zero. So this line and this line provide problem formulation of this problem. Next, we can analyze passage to infinity when delta goes to zero. So because I do not have a lot of time, I just skip this one. So it's possible to justify passage to infinity when delta goes to infinity. And we obtain boundary conditions when we have zero friction of the positive crack face, as well as we can justify a passage to limit when delta goes to zero. So this means, in fact, so this limit case corresponds to the situation when we have no crack, no hurt, the crack disappears. So this is equilibrium equations and boundary condition, as well as junction conditions. I do not have time for comments. And also, it's possible to pass to the limit when rigidity parameter of thin inclusion tends to infinity, so, and damage parameter is fixed. In the limit, we obtain the following situation. In fact, we have a one rigid inclusions D with the wings B1, B2, and this is problem formulation is given with fixed damage parameter delta. So this is justified, and the last step corresponds to situation when we have a break of the inclusions at this junction point break. So B1 and B2 are independent, no connection between B1 and B2. In this case, we have the following problem formulation. The following problem formulation presented here. Damage parameter is fixed, but we have elasticity relations, equation for the thin inclusions, boundary conditions for elastic body and for thin inclusions, U is equal to rho from the space on infinitesimal rigid displacement on D, glue conditions, inequality type boundary conditions, as well as junction conditions. Junction conditions would be different. In this case, bending moment, the second derivative of vertical displacement at this point is equal to zero. And the last three relations also have a different point compared to the previous one. So in this case, if we have a break between B1 and B2, problem formulation would be different, and this problem formulation is presented at this and this slide. So all passages to limit are justified, and we know how to formulate limit problems. Thank you very much for the attention.
Thank you, Professor Klubnev. I think we have just a few minutes if anyone has any question.
Maybe I will ask. thank you for your talk. And what could you comment about some maybe numerical results to your nice theory?
I have to say that this problem is quite new. But I would like to go back to this slide. To this slide, where I have shown several papers concerning the situation like this. So we have two thin inclusions and the junction point, and we have to describe boundary condition at this point for different thin inclusions. For problems like this, we have a number of numerical results, and my co-author Tatiana Popova published a number of papers. They are not shown here on this slide, but they are published, and she can she has a number of numerical results resulted to this junction problem. As for the problem I have delivered, this result is very new, and up to now we have no results. I hope that we will obtain the results in the near future. Thank you very much for the question.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Professor. Is there any other question?
I have one question. The question is as follows. Is it possible this thin inclusion described by curves, not straight lines?
You have in mind this picture?
Yes, in this picture.
We analyzed, if we speak about Euler-Bernoulli model or Timoshenko model, of course we use well-known models of Euler-Bernoulli, Timoshenko for describing thin elastic beams. But if you consider so-called thin rigid inclusions, they may be curvilinear, of course. And we considered many situations, in particular when rigid inclusions and elastic inclusions provide different geometrial figure, T-shape, and so on. So it's possible. But if you speak about thin elastic inclusions, we consider only straight lines, it's sure. Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much.